Today we're exploring an abandoned Miami detention center that opened its doors in 1974.
Ledger. So this was the office.
Where is it? Probably where they did live.
What else is there? That's cool. That's all fire damage.
As part of a master plan involving the construction of jails and local communities to serve the local population, this facility was the only one built under the concept and would close just 2 years later in 1976.
In this room, it's like...
Like a filing room?
Yeah. Cheetah.
Is that him?
No.
Discharge?
Spray paint cans. This used to be where camera used to be. Oh, this is where we were. Clinic.
This facility transferred hands and served as a work release center until its closure sometime in mid-2010.
It's wide open. Oh, that's razor wire. That's not wide open. Oh. Ooh. Pull it open. Nope.
Are you recording?
Yeah. You can talk, it's fine. Oh, they do not connect. How did they get in there to graffiti it? Okay, hold on. Does this thing have any locks in the door? It does not. Personnel use only. I feel like I'm personnel. Oh, wait a minute. There's a sensor right here. It's fine, it doesn't open anyway. It probably shut them so that if someone did get in here, it wouldn't accidentally shut one of those doors on themselves. Is that just outside? The... I don't know. It is hot. So there's only two cell blocks, essentially.
Many locations, including this one, were closed in lieu of more modern and up-to-date facilities.
This is all just open air. I bet this is where the kitchen was. Because it's all open air. Well, I mean, it has ductwork too. That's confusing. Really confused as to what this is. Oh wait, what is it?
It's a blood pressure cuff.
Put it on.
Thank you so much for joining me on this explore. Please be sure to hit that like button for the YouTube algorithm and subscribe so you don't miss out on more of my urbex adventures.